Looking forward to this JV action. It's a little bit shorter. Here's the kickoff. We'll keep you up to date on the time frame. The Shamrocks, that is, running it back on his feet, and some good work taken down at the 45. That's number 27, David Stanley, for the Shamrocks.
Nice neck tackle there. Grabbed him by the back of the head and brought him down. It almost looked as though we were going to have another first kickoff brought back for a touchdown, but he did a good job of coming over and catching up on the play.
Well, we saw, again, as you mentioned, LaCosta run that all the way back for a touchdown in the varsity game, and that time David Stanley got it all the way back to the 45. These are the JVs. The game is a little bit shorter. It's 8 minute quarters. Stop time. And quarterbacking for the Shamrocks is Malcolm Chandler. It is first down and 10. Ball is on the 45 yard line for the Shamrocks. Chandler drops back, dumps it off, and it's caught on his feet and still running. There's some flags on the play. The Shamrocks 24. All the way down inside the 40-yard line. And that's Carl Maines for the Shamrocks. And nifty piece of running. We're going to see where the flags are called.
Right, well, it's going to come back. The play won't stand. It looked as though there was a clip, and the referee called a personal foul. So a nice run, nice screen pass, a little dump pass off to the right, but it'll go for naught as there was a clip on the play.
These are the little guys, the JVs, the seventh graders. And they certainly are a little out there, but they're fun to watch.
Well, the quarterback's one of the tallest guys out there on the field. Of course, that's the thing you like to see. But especially with some of that running back who just made the play, he's so little, there's really not a lot to tackle. And if he's got any speed to go with it, makes him very difficult to bring down because he is so low to the ground. So we could see a lot of extended runs here today, as these kids are pretty tough to bring down.
It'll be first and long yardage. First and make that 25 for the Shamrocks. The ball is on their 32-yard line. And Malcolm Chandler will line up behind his troops, try and get things going for the JV Shamrocks. Chandler on the pitch, and it's just caught and held onto by Steve Bertrand. And he did all he could just to hold on to that football, Jay.
Yeah, I think it looked like a mix-up between Bertrand and Carl Maines as to who was actually going to take that lateral back from the quarterback. And neither one of them knew who was going to come up with it. And finally, Bertrand fell on it, but they didn't get anything out of it in the end.
And the Shamrocks, 26-yard line.
So now first and 10 for the little green on the Portsmouth 26-yard line. And believe it or not, we've got some flakes coming down.
It is starting to snow. I was wondering, I did take a shower this morning, so it wasn't dandruff. It looks like it's going to be a little bit of snow. There's a lot of clouds moving in from the, I don't know if that's the west or so, but it's really starting to cloud over, and people are starting to put blankets over their heads and put their hats on, and we could end up getting some snow.
Like they say, you don't like the weather in New England, you wait five minutes. We had a great conditions, a little bit cold for the varsity game. There's motion procedure on the little green. They'll be called 5 yards. And then within 5-10 minutes, we've got snow spitting down here.
And it looked like they were offside. They jumped the gun too much for Dover, and coach is coming out to explain to them that they need to wait a little bit for their quarterback before they jump.
So 5:25 to go in this first quarter. There's no score between the Shamrock JVs and the little green from Dover. In at quarterback for the little green is number 17, Steve Paisley. And on the handoff, the little green tried to go around the left side, still on his feet. And he may score. That's number 12, Jeff Stacy. And Stacy is right down to the goal line. It'll be close.
Nice cutback on the play there. He cut back twice. He was almost out of bounds on the left-hand far sideline. Then all of a sudden he cuts back to the right, and it looks as though that Eddie Stokes was going to be able to bring him in, and then he cuts back into the inside again. So nice, nifty running by the little green, and it looks like they could go in again.
No scores of yet. Little green are on the right on the goal line, about a yard to go. It'll be first down and goal to go.
Big goal line stand here needed by the Shamrocks.
Well, we saw the varsities pull it off a couple times. And Steve Paisley lines up behind his crew. Takes a snap, and we're going to have motion called. some type of procedure, most likely going against Dover.
And that'll back him up, and you really don't want to do that when you've got a first and goal situation. If you're right on the goal line, you want to be able to put it in right away and not have to get yourself in on a first and goal from the five. It's worth it to wait for the quarterback to call and then try to plow it in. Now you've got five more yards to go, and it gives the defense a little more room to spread out. There you look at some of the JVs on the sidelines.
The little Shamrocks. So now it is first and goal from just outside the five-yard line. Steve Paisley lining up behind his troops. He's got four tries to push it in. And that time it was Portsmouth offsides. It looks like number 67 for the Shamrocks, Adam Fiandanka.
Yeah, he got down into a set position, and then it looks like he got up and really didn't look like he was going to jump, but it, he got out of a set position, and as soon as he did, the referee blew the whistle through the flag.
Clock winding down, 3:34 to go in this first quarter. There is no score. This is the JV version of the Portsmouth Shamrocks against the Little Green. Earlier, the varsity beat the Dover Little Green 18-14 in a real thriller. So on second down now, or check that, still first down, Paisley fumbles the ball, and I think he did a good job just to fall on it and retain possession.
Very alert play. It looks like the defense had stood him up, and then all of a sudden the ball popped loose, and he got down and covered it up, and they'll wait again and go on second down.
Second and goal from the four.
Frank Ott did a good job to jar that ball loose.
It's interesting. A lot of the little Shamrocks are wearing the sun visors, and now that it's starting to get dark, plus daylight saving time, if it starts getting dark out, I don't know if they're going to still want to wear those visors.
I don't know. I have not dealt with those personally. I'm not sure if that's something that you can easily pop on and off your helmet. I think at this impressionable age, a lot of them like to be like maybe Charles White.
Exactly.
Wear that visor. Here's a sweep, and it looks like the Little Green are going to push it in. And that's Pat Sullivan, number 24. 6-yard run.
And great blocking by Steve Jennison, the upback. He cleared out the inside and allowed for him to go through for a touchdown. So the Green Wave get on the board first.
Drawing first blood here in the JVs. 2:24 of this first quarter. 2:24 to go, that is. And a 6-yard run by Mr. Sullivan.
And we're into the second game, and we still haven't seen an extra point tried. They're going to go for the two.
And they go to the air. Nice little defensive work by the Shamrock secondary. That was number 21, Billy Bertrand. He got a hand on it and just knocked it down.
And I know that Aiden Moore, was our director in this game, was upset that he didn't get to see a drop kick in the first game. And once again, they stick on the ground and try to get the two-point conversion this time. It doesn't work, but Dover still has a 6-0 lead.
Well, that brief snowstorm has lifted. Still a little bit of squall activity out there. 2:24 to go now, 6-0 in favor of the Little Green. And these are the Little Green.
There's some real small guys out there. I'm looking at number 41. And if he gets his hand on the ball for the Little Shamrocks, he could really do something with a return. And don't see his name down here on the roster. But like I said, they're tough to bring down once they get their hand on the ball.
There's the kickoff, and it's fielded by number 44 for Portsmouth, and he's taken down at the 41-yard line. That was Adam Roberts.
And it looks as though he fumbled it, and number 61 for the Little Green came up with it. And so they turn it over on after a fumble on the kickoff.
Well, of course, that's not what the Shamrocks want to have happen after that touchdown. Immediately on the kickoff, give the ball right back to Little Green.
Well, it keeps the momentum on the Dover Little Green side, and they got it in the first time they had the ball, and now they can set up offense again. And if you're on the defense, you don't want to be out there all day. You want to be able to get off the field and at least get four downs of rest. You don't want to have to keep pushing them back again on consecutive sets of downs.
Under 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. It is 6-0 in favor of the Little Green from Dover. And we see coaches from both teams out on the field helping out, monitoring. There's a little end around run around the left side.
Nice open field tackle there by John Hernandez. It looks as though he was going to be able to turn the corner and at least get a first down, but Hernandez came in and brought him down. Good tackle by Hernandez.
That was Steve Jennison, number 43 for Dover. And I'd give him about 4 yards on the pickup. Should be 2nd and 6.
Okay,
now.
2nd and 7.
2nd and a long 6.
And a number of parents and friends of the Shamrocks have stayed for the second game, the JV game, and that's nice to see.
That is good to see because these kids are just as deserving of all the attention and as the big boys, and in a year they will be the big boys. New quarterback in, and there's the pitch. Executed very well. Held on to the ball was number 24, Pat Sullivan, and Jeff Stacy was at quarterback. They have him playing for Steve Paisley.
That was interesting. It looked like it was going to be a keeper, but they ran the option, and they ran it effectively. The toss was a little high, and Paisley had to go up and get it, but that was a nice option run. They committed the defense to tackling the quarterback and left him out in the open.
That's a tough play at any level. I mean, I see the professionals screwing that play up all the time, although it's not used all that often
sure.
in the NFL, but even on the college level, the option is probably one of the toughest plays to execute because there's so much going on at once, and the quarterback has to make that quick decision
exactly.
whether to hold it, and if he does, you know, his running mate doesn't know if it's coming to him or not because it's all up to the quarterback.
Exactly.
Here's Stacy with the keeper around the right side. Nice little cut inside, gets down to the 26.
See, that time the Portsmouth defense didn't commit automatically to the quarterback. Number 93 for the Shamrocks, Jason Lancette, kept his eye on the running back coming towards the outside because he knew that there was a possibility that he might dish it off, especially in the colleges where the option is most often used. They'll practice throwing the option to their halfback as often as they do passing.
Dominic Carroll on the takedown for the Shamrocks. And that's the end of the first quarter. It's 6-0 in favor of Dover. And the teams will change sides. And we will stay right with you as the second quarter is just about to begin. Again, 8-minute quarters here for the JVs, the little guys. And Jay, you'd like to remind us that this game is being brought to us by Hunkins.
Yes, this game being brought to you by Hunkins Home Improvement, and you can call them in their Greenland office at 431-2690 or call their toll-free number 1-800-842-SIDE. That's 1-800-842-SIDE.
And, of course, the Shamrock Boosters also helping to fund this broadcast. Stacy will hold on. He's going to put it up. That's a nice arm. Oh, couldn't hold it. Hit him right a little bit lower than the numbers, right around the midsection. Number 32 for Dover, and that was Shannon Greenow. But that was a good pass by Stacy. He got some arm into it.
It certainly was. And one thing I've noticed is interesting about this game is that they let the coaches stay on the field during the play, and the coaches actually call the plays on the field and keep them in during the game. So they'll just back off and let the kids execute the plays that they call.
That's good, though. I believe in that move because, you know, seventh grade is still a young age, and you like to have the direction right out there with them. And they're not a presence on the field that they interfere with the play at all. They're just there, you know, reassuring support, and they keep the little guys in line.
Exactly. It would be interesting, though, to see a kid audibleize on his coach as a JV.
It is 6:44 to go in the second quarter. The score is 6-0 in favor of the Little Green.
And we've got a few more flakes again. It looks like it wants to snow, but it seems as though no matter what it does, we're not going to get any kind of accumulation.
It's trying awfully hard.
It is.
Now, we don't expect any accumulation today. A little squall activity.
Squall.
It'll be 2nd down and probably 15 yards to go for the Little Green, 15, 16. The ball is spotted right around the 32-yard line. And the clock is running with 6 minutes to go in the second quarter. Stacy will drop back, stumbled. Now he wants to put it up. Lots of pressure. And he's taken down, sacked hard by number 71, Dominic Carroll.
And it looks as though he had plenty of time to throw. That is a sack that was basically caused by good play by the secondary of the Shamrocks. He had as much time as you really need to give a quarterback to make up his mind, but there was no man open. And finally, the wall just sort of caved in on Dover.
So some great defensive pass rushing by the Shamrocks. And that really puts the Little Green in a hole. They have to get the ball down to about the 16, 17-yard line. And the ball is spotted at the 37. So in this situation, it's the third down in a cab ride.
The zip code.
Stacy back to pass. He can throw that football. And it's picked off. No, it is caught.
Pass completed.
Caught by number 83.
Nice takeaway.
Ryan Barkley. I could have sworn that was going to be picked off, and Barkley, I think, stripped the ball out of the Portsmouth player's hands.
It looked as though, too, I was going to say that it looked as though the quarterback was throwing into a crowd, and Shannon Greeno, who lined up on the left side, was open briefly, and he might have had more luck going over there, but as it turned out, a nice catch.
So most of that cab fare, as it'll be fourth down and about, call it 6 or 7 yards. Stacy will drop back to pass again. That young man has a good arm.
He can really rifle it in there, and that time I think he really might have thrown too much into a crowd, double coverage on the right side, but you're right, when he wants to, he can rifle it in there. So it's a nice, straight, sharp ball.
And he kicks for the varsity team.
24-yard line.
So, the Portsmouth Shamrocks will take over on possession of downs. It'll be first down and 10 for the Shamrocks. They have the ball on their own 24-yard line. Just about 4 minutes to go in this first half. It is 6-0 in favor of the Dover Little Green.
This would be a nice way to get a nice long drive and pretty much run out the clock, too, and try to get on the board before the end of the half.
Shamrocks are going to pass, and it's caught. That's number 37 for the Shamrocks. And he's still on his feet, number 27, that is. He will break all the way for a touchdown. Number 27, and of course that is David Stanley.
David Stanley breaking it open, and I don't think we saw it that often in the first game, but right. Skip Tilley said that he was going to pull that play out of his pocket if he needed it, and it's called ice cream. That's where you have four blockers lining up on the far right-hand side. They throw a simple screen pass, and you've got the wall set up ready to go, and they executed it to perfection. And it looks as though Dover even knew what might be happening, but they still couldn't do anything about it. Excellent blocking and a good run by Stanley.
Well, Tilley had mentioned that we might see that in the varsity game. We've been told that Stanley averages one of those every week.
So he's got the speed to go along with it.
Quite an offensive player on the conversion. A big hit at the line. And the Shamrocks continue to falter on their conversions attempts today. The varsity failed on three attempts. So we have a tie ball game, 6-6 with 3:12 to go in this first half.
Well, it's interesting. It seems to me that even in the first game, we've been seeing them try to run the conversion each time on towards the inside, and they just haven't had any luck. We were talking about how the teams tend to run, Dover tends to run the option, and that might have been a nice way to have the quarterback bootleg and try to run it in on the outside.
So the ice cream play is unveiled, and the touchdown by David Stanley. There's a little trooper. That's number 24, Carl Maines.
Well, it looks as though Dave Stanley's going to have another one of those Shamrock decals affixed to his helmet for a great play, contribution to the team.
Just over 3 minutes to go, and here's the kick by the Shamrocks. Pretty good kick, I might add. And it gets away from the Little Green down at the 15-yard line, fielded by Stacy, and Stacy still on his feet at the 20, taken down hard at the 21-yard line, but he did well just to hold on to that ball and pick it up.
I think some confusion on the play. Mike Bruce looked as though he was in perfect position to field the kickoff, and all of a sudden he decided to block, knowing that he had a back man, and one was thinking the other was going to do what they didn't do, and they had to go chase it down, but still a good run back.
2:39 to go and ticking. This ball game is tied up 6-6. Pat Sullivan scored on a 6-yard run for the Little Green. And then David Stanley, 74 yards on the ice cream play. With 3:15 to go this second half, and we are tied up at 6-6. Neither team was able to capitalize on their 2-point conversion. And Little Green have the ball. They have first down. The ball is on their 22-yard line. Stacy hands off, but nothing doing as the Shamrocks just stormed on that left side.
Yeah, the offensive line was ready for that play, and nothing was going to come from that. Number 74 for the Shamrocks.
Eric Champagne.
Eric Champagne was in on the play, along with the nose tackle, 67, and he got in on it as well. Looking him up, that being Adam Fiandaka. And they really caused that play to go nowhere.
Clock is running with a minute 40 left to go, and surprise, no flags on that play. Here goes the Little Green. That's number 24, Pat Sullivan. And he gets around the right side, taken down right around the 26-yard line by the Shamrocks.
Good job there to keep his balance on that counterplay. Eric Gibson had him wrapped up and was spinning him around to bring him down, but he still kept on going, so credit the runner for keeping his balance and staying on his feet for some extra yardage.
Note number 77 on the offensive line for the Little Green, Jason Bosworth. I'd like to see under his helmet, see what kind of haircut he has.
I was going to say, or if he wears those blue sunglasses during the day.
The Boss, the Little Boss for the Little Green. And he's on that left end. It is third down and 5 to go for Dover. Stacy will drop back. He's an effective passer, and he's rolling out now. Look at him air that ball out. He's got his man and caught. Oh, a tremendous reception by Ryan Barclay, and you really couldn't ask for a finer pass from Stacy.
He threw that ball about approximately 30 yards. He threw those, cross field. He threw that ball about 30 yards straight, not a lot of loft on it, and really pinpointed that pass to where he wanted to put it.
Very much impressed with the arm of Jeff Stacy. And a fine catch as well by Barclay. He had to catch that over his shoulder, looking to the outside. And he gets the ball over midfield, taken down at the 48-yard line in Portsmouth territory.
He's tall. He's got the look of a quarterback. And if he keeps that arm up, he's going to be a positive future for Dover's football.
28 seconds to go in this half. We'd like to see if Dover can get on the board here. The time is running out. Stacy airs it out again. That time, just underthrows Barclay. There was double coverage down there for the Shamrocks.
Yeah, it looks as though he just underthrew him, and Steve Gerbino was playing good coverage on that play. He underthrew it, but Gerbino had the wits to cut back and see if he could make the interception, knowing that it would be thrown a little short.
Second down and 10 for the Little Green. They have the ball just inside the Portsmouth territory. They're at about the 48, 49-yard line.
Nose tackle Afiandaka coming out. Looks as though he might have hurt his leg a little bit. Sitting down, he looks okay, but
shake it off, Adam.
Miss the play.
Stacy drops back again. Five-step drop. That time he overthrows Barclay again, and we're starting to see that's the combination. Stacy to Barclay. And here we are up in the booth.
Well,
looks
as though he makes his mind up from the minute he snaps the ball who he wants to go to, and that time double coverage once again by the Shamrocks, and he probably could have looked at his alternate receiver and seen if there was something else going on there, but he decided to rifle it in, and a lot of times quarterbacks with rifles will tend to do that, try to beat coverage and really nail it in there. That time it didn't work, but as we've seen other times, it does.
Stacy will fire it again. On third down, there are 4 seconds to go in this half.
And you got to credit the Shamrock offensive line for really rushing the quarterback pretty well. He takes only a two or three step drop, and he has to get rid of that ball pretty quickly. So he's been throwing off his heels on that play and couldn't get the zip on the ball that he wanted to.
Well, he's predominantly looked to Barclay, and Barclay has come down with a few nice catches. I haven't seen Mr. Stacy pass to anyone else. That time, almost picked off. He was looking for Barclay again. And number 20, T.J. Dyer, knocked it down, and that is the end. of the first half. The score is tied up 6-6. Real good ball game here. The JV Shamrocks against the JV Little Green from Dover. And we'll bring you second half action right after this.
Pumpkins has it. Windows and doors for comfort and beauty too.
For quality, guaranteed CertainTeed solid vinyl replacement windows, CertainTeed solid vinyl siding, blown insulation, storm gutters, and all home improvements. Hunkin's Home Improvements.
And down at the concession stand, like to send a hearty thank you to the people at the concession stand. They let us eat for free here. Channel 12, our whole production crew, probably about 10 of us maybe total.
And we've done a number of road games, and I must say the concession stand here is about has about as much variety as any place I've ever been.
And these dogs are darn good. It is 6-6. We are just about ready for third quarter action.
Dominic Carroll will kick off for the Shamrocks.
The Shamrocks will be kicking away. And I'm trying to get that number for you. Turn around there, little guy. Number 71, Dominic Carroll will be kicking off for the Shamrocks and back to receive.
Looks like number
Little
12.
Green, yep, number 12, Jeff Stacy. He looks like they're all-purpose man. The JVs, we saw White doing everything for the Varsities. It's a short kick. It's fielded midfield at around the 40. And that's their tight end, or their wide receiver, Ryan Barclay. He gets it all the way back to about the 45-yard line in Portsmouth territory.
So they get a break, and they get some good field position to start off the second half, and it's going to be interesting to see if Dover tries to mix it up a little bit more than they did at the end of the second quarter. Granted, they wanted to stop the clock a little bit more, but they almost exclusively passed, and almost exclusively passed to the same person. So we'll have to see how Portsmouth defenses that and see how Dover tries to work their way towards the end zone again.
Well, Stacy has shown the ability to air it out, but I think precisely as you mentioned, he has to go to a couple more receivers than just Barkley. Stacy on the keeper, the pitch out, and good pursuit by the Shamrocks. Take him down at the 48, that is. That was Pat Sullivan for the Little Green.
And John Hernandez doing an excellent job pursuing the play. He never allows himself to get distracted until he finds his man, it seems, and he was able to push off a couple Dover blockers and get to his man and make a nice ankle tackle.
All the scoring coming in the first half. Pat Sullivan, a 6-yard run for the Little Green. They failed on their 2-point conversion. And then David Stanley on the ice cream play, a 74-yard touchdown. Actually, it was a run, but he caught the ball on the sweep, on the screen pass, that is, on the ice cream. And they failed on their 2-point conversion, so it's tied at 6. There's a little pitch out to Stacy, and he's around the corner on the right side, taken down from behind at the 40-yard line.
Number
74 with good pursuit, Eric Champagne.
Yeah, and it looks as though Josh Hudson, number 1 for the Shamrocks, was pursuing them in the play. He spent the entire first half covering Shannon Greeno, who's the other receiver who didn't get any action. And they ran right towards him, and he was able to hold out the play. Couldn't make the tackle, but he got him sidetracked enough so that the other Shamrocks were able to make the play.
Clock is running. 6 minutes to go in this third quarter, tied up at 6. These are the JVs, the Little Shamrocks, and the Little Green from Dover. Seventh graders.
And looking at those lines, they're not as small as I might have thought they would have been.
No. Actually, from up here, they all look small, but when we got down on the field, they're pretty good size. Fumbled snap, but Stacy, he's trying to elude his chasers, but he won't do so. He's still on his feet at the 50, gets it all the way back to almost the line of scrimmage. What a valiant effort by Stacy. We used to call that muckle.
Champagne.
Fumbled snap, and Dominic Carroll, number 71 for the Shamrocks, made him pay for it. The minute that he tried to get the ball back, Carroll was all over him and jarred that ball loose.
Stacy probably felt like he was the only white shirt out there. With the ball back
green.
Around the 50-yard line, it was fumbled, and on the pitch it was bobbled. Stacy had to turn all the way back to his 45, elude a couple of runners coming in for the Shamrocks, a couple of tacklers, that is.
And good pursuit on the play as well by Eddie Stokes, number 2, for the Shamrocks, as he was able to push back the runner and allow Carroll to come in, and the other Shamrocks, and make the play.
6-6. 4:50 to go, third quarter. Stacy dropping back to pass. He airs it out again. Just overthrows Barkley. And in the air, Jeff Stacy threw that ball almost 30 yards.
Yeah, there was good coverage, it seemed, by the Shamrocks, and he was really the only open receiver. That time he was able to find Barkley, but just laid it out just beyond his fingertips for an incomplete pass. And they're still sticking to the air.
It'll be first down for the Shamrocks as they recover on possession. I'd like to remind you again, this game being brought to you by Hunkins Home Improvements. They are serving the Seacoast year-round. They would like to serve you, too. And you can call them anytime at 431-2690. Also, you can use their toll-free number, 1-800-842-SIDE. Call that number within New Hampshire. Again, Hunkins Home Improvements and, of course, the Shamrock Boosters helping bring you this broadcast today.
And we saw some people watching the game starting to put the blankets on. It's getting a little colder here than it was when the game first started.
Well, we saw the flakes of snow, so that attests to the temperature. We'll have encroachment, I believe, on the little green. I didn't see anyone on the Shamrock side move.
I thought Matt Brewster probably moved, and on the other side, another two of the safety people blitzing, who looked like they were going to blitz for Dover, and I think they got a little over-anxious. So it will go against Dover.
First down five.
Malcolm Chandler, a quarterback, takes a snap, a quick handoff, a little draw up the middle, and a nice piece of running by Carl Maines. He gets all the way down to just about the 42-yard line.
Well, you don't always have an opening when you're running back, and sometimes you have to create your own. And Carl Maines just sort of took a few Dover people for a ride and said, we're going to get about 5 or 6 yards, and really just plowed through. Good running, good powerful running.
David Roy on that offensive line for the Shamrocks, as well as Frank Ott. Try and run down all those names for you as they come up. 83, you see wide receiver. That is Steven Gerbino. There's the pitch, and
Stanley.
Off to the races is David Stanley. He'll have a touchdown.
Stanley in the end zone for six.
And David Stanley takes it in all the way. It looks as though he was going to go to the outside at first, but then saw a tremendous hole on the inside and decided to cut in and go all the way. And I tell you, once that guy gets a head of steam under him, there is no stopping David Stanley. He went all the way, and that'll give a 12-6 lead for the Shamrocks. Well, it'll be interesting to see if we finally get our first drop kick, but from all indications, they're going to go for that two-point conversion again.
That's the second touchdown of the game for Mr. Stanley. This one, a 42-yarder. He's racking up the yards, 74 yards on that ice cream play earlier in the game. And on the two-point conversion, Chandler rolling out, and he'll be taken down.
Chandler.
So again, the Shamrocks today with their varsity and JV combined are 0-for-5 on the two-point conversions.
Well, that time it looks like they did try to swing it towards the outside for the two-point conversion, but Dover was ready for it, and they were stringing it out nicely, not allowing any major holes to get through, and unsuccessful once again on the two-point conversion.
So 12-6 for the Shamrocks. They have taken command. They gave up 6 points early in the game to Dover, and they've answered with 12 points of their own, both on David Stanley touchdowns.
And it'll be a matter now to see if the defense can hold them. Of course, it's very important each time you score that you come out the next series of downs and shut down their offense. It really gives you a good feeling to be able to not let them respond with a touchdown again, so we'll wait and see how it goes.
There's a kickoff. It's fielded at the 30-yard line. And the little green man falls down. Number 25 for the little green, Mike Bruce.
Yeah, it looks as though he was trying to let Barkley block for him and lead the way. And then I think he stepped on Barkley's heel and went down and slipped. So you can almost credit Barkley with a tackle on that one.
Clock is running. 2:15 to go in this third quarter. 12-6 in favor of the Shamrocks. And the little green will start, first down and 10 from their own 39-yard line.
Little confusion by Shamrocks as to who was supposed to come in and who was going out, and now it seems they have everything cleared up. And
Frank Ott coming out to the sidelines. That's Mr. Ott. 86, Brandon Sullivan, you see on the right end of that defensive line. It is first down and 10 for Dover. And a fumble on the snap. Stacy turns around and falls on it. We'll wait to see when they peel all the bodies off, who still has it?
It seems as though the snap, the center man might have had a trouble figuring out where the quarterback was, because he really sort of hiked it to nobody. And Dover had to go over and fall on the ball and just try to recover and maintain possession. In case you're wondering, that is not a halftime show. If you're hearing it in the background, the Portsmouth Varsity Clipper Band is practicing. And of course, they do many great halftime shows here.
Some more troubles on the snap for Jeff Stacy, and he's taken down now at the 30-yard line.
So once again, Dover having a tough time transferring the ball from one man to the other. It seems to pop up into the air all the time, and that might have something to do with the hands starting to get a little cold. It's tough to really pinpoint where you're going to dish the ball off or where you're going to throw it. So they've got to do a little bit better job holding onto the ball.
12-6 Shamrocks. These are the JV crews out here today. The Shamrocks, JVs, and the Little Green from Dover. 37 seconds to go in this third quarter. Looks like Dover will get one more playoff. Maybe two. It is third down and quite a long distance. Jeff Stacy, and it'll be even longer on fourth down. The Dover, to get a first down, have to get up to the 48-yard line, and Jeff Stacy was tackled back on the 16.
And looking at the the Shamrock defense, it's interesting to see that by allowing the coach to be on the field, that being, I believe, Kurt Jones for the Shamrocks, not only can he call plays and tell him what he wants the defense to do, but he can also correct things while they're going in between plays. He can tell certain players what he wants them to do or how they should change from one play to another.
There was a flag on the play. It looks like it will be marked off. Well, we'll wait and see to get the official word. Looks like it'll be marked off against the Shamrocks.
And we'll have to wait and see what the call was. I didn't see the specific foul.
Has to be some kind of dead ball foul because I didn't see anything. That was a face mask.
Face mask against the Shamrocks.
So that gives the Little Green a little better chance at it with fourth down. The ball is on the 38. They have to get it up. Well, it's on the 39. They have to get it up to the 49. So fourth and 10. Stacy rolling out. He's hit as he throws, and the ball just flutters helplessly. Incomplete, and the Shamrocks will take over on downs. There's 2 seconds to go in this third quarter.
And that was a good play by Eric Champagne to smother the quarterback. Not only did he want to get, he didn't come in looking like he was going to get the sack. He came in just trying to block the pass, and that's what he did. He got his hands up and blocked the pass.
Shamrocks
6. So it looks like it's the end of the third quarter, and they will switch sides and head into this fourth quarter. A nice defensive stand by the Shamrocks so far after having scored that touchdown. It's nice to shut them down, and they did.
Well, the Little Green scored early, 2:24 to go in the first quarter. Pat Sullivan on a 6-yard run. But since then, as you mentioned, Jay, the Shamrocks have really tightened up on D.
And there's a look at one of the footballs used in this, maybe not directly used in this game. They get a little dirty in the course of a game.
Okay, now it is a punting situation. Forgive me, that wasn't fourth down. It is fourth down now.
And we've got movement. We'll have to see if it's on the offense or the defense, but I did see Dominic Carroll come over. We'll have to see if Shannon Greeno drew him off or if he just jumped.
Certainly the defense was offsides, but whether he was drawn over or not, apparently the officials say he wasn't. It'll still be fourth down and 5 now. It'll be interesting to see if Dover will change their game plan and maybe not opt to punt. With 7:40 to go in this ball game, it is 12-6 in favor of the Shamrocks.
Well, it looks as though they have plenty of time left.
And it appears that Dover has opted not to punt, and they will try. Unless the coach is back there to punt. There's a flag on the play. Jeff Stacy doesn't get anywhere, nowhere close to the first down. We'll wait to see how the refs sort out that flag.
And if it's a flag against Dover, and it looks like it is, that's a good break for the Shamrocks, as they really only had 10 defensive players who were in the game. Stanley had gone back as if he was going to field the punt. And then as soon as he saw that Dover was not going to punt the ball, he had to run back into the play. So for that play, the Shamrocks really only had 10 defensive players.
The motion denied. So now, it'll be first and 10 for the Shamrocks. They will recover on possessions now. They'll have the ball at the 43-yard line. First down and 10. They lead 12-6.
Excuse me there, Scott. That's a bigger play than normal in that not only did they hold them and they get the ball back, but they've got good field position again. And by going on a fourth down and trying to make that play, Dover took the chance of giving them field position, and the Shamrocks take over in Dover territory.
First down and 10, ball on the 44-yard line, 43-44.
First down 10.
Chandler drops back. He'll pass this time. And just overthrows his man.
And another interesting wrinkle by the Shamrock offense, as we saw the wishbone there. They lined up in the wishbone formation. And they passed off of it. So we're seeing all kinds of different plays and formations run by the Portsmouth Shamrock team.
Chandler was looking for Steven Gerbino. Overthrew him by a yard or two.
Skip Tilley is not afraid, even at this young age, to put some interesting wrinkles into the offense and the defense.
Interesting to note, the clock still runs, Jay, on an incomplete pass. And looks like we got the ice cream setting up. Will Dover be able to adjust? The pass is complete by Stanley. Now he'll throw the ball, and the man is wide open. Oh, just overthrows him. David Stanley, that time, was looking for Gerbino. And it was a nice throw by Stanley just off the fingertips of Gerbino.
And Gerbino was wide open. He was all alone. And just when you think you've seen everything that Skip Tilley can pull out of his pocket, he's got another play and another wrinkle on that. And Dover looked like they were kind of prepared for it. As soon as he saw those blockers moving out towards the near sideline, some Dover people committed to it as well. But nobody covered Gerbino. They thought that they were going to throw the screen, and that was it. But I tell you, you never know with the Shamrocks. They can come at you with so many different weapons.
That's one of those plays we used to dream up in the dirt, in the sandlot ball.
Exactly.
5:30 to go. All kinds of offsides. Looks like encroachment against Dover. We'll see if Dover, the Shamrocks, drew them off. They did. Motion on Portsmouth. So with the clock continuing to run, with 5 minutes to go, 12-6, in favor of the Shamrocks, the ball will be spotted now on the 48.
And it's good to see a number of Dover people who stayed for the JV game, to see their people out there, and a number of people hanging around for the JV Shamrock game. Good to see. On a crisp, cool, bordering on cold Sunday afternoon at the end of October.
I'll give you cold. It's cold.
We'll grant that.
And Stanley trying to break out around the right side, and 24 made the tackle. Pat Sullivan, he had some help.
And Nathan McIvine, it looks as though he tried to make one of those jersey tackles where you grab a piece of the jersey and drag him down. But they were not going to buy that, and ended up turning what should have been a loss into a mild gain.
So now fourth down, and still about 15 yards to go, with 4:15 to go on this ball game, 12-6 in favor of the JV Shamrocks. Chandler will stay in, and we'll see what Skip Tilley has in mind for this play. Four wide receivers set to go up.
Hail Mary.
Chandler drops back, three-step, five-step, and he gets hit as he lets the ball go, and it just flutters to the turf.
Yeah, it looks as though Jason Bosworth got in there and got a hand on the pass, and what could have been a first down pass down the far sideline ends up being a flutter ball that goes harmlessly away.
Clock running with 3.5 minutes to go in this ball game, 12-6. Jay?
When you think about it, on fourth down, it usually is, especially with smaller kids, you might as well go for it on fourth down, because if you just throw the ball far down, which is what the Shamrocks were trying to do, it's almost as good as a punt if you complete it. If not, you don't lose a lot of ground.
Stacy does a good job to get away from his man, throws it downfield, caught, and then dropped by Barclay. Will they give him the reception? No. They say it's incomplete. I thought they might have given the reception and then called the fumble.
Yeah, the official saying that he juggled the ball. Probably one thing that Barclay would have wanted to do though, even though after he dropped the ball, he did a wise thing and pounced on it because he wasn't sure if they were going to call it an incomplete or a complete pass. So he wanted to make sure that they at least retained possession, and the official was quick to let him know with the hands up and down that it was a juggle and incomplete pass.
So now second down and 10 yards still for the Dover Little Green. They trail 12-6 with 2.5 minutes to go in this ball game. They're trying to mount some sort of drive to tie this thing up.
Second down, 10.
On second and 10, Stacy will hand off to his back, number 24, Pat Sullivan. Sullivan will pick up a couple of yards, two or three tough yards there for Sullivan.
He did a good job. Eric Champagne had him at the line of scrimmage and didn't really have any leverage on him. It just sort of hung on and allowed him to get about two or three yards, but finally Champagne was able to drag him down and make the play.
With a little stop in the action here, 2:10 to go, I'd like to remind you again and thank our sponsors, the Portsmouth Shamrocks, Shamrock Organization, and Hunkins Home Improvement. You know, a lot of people say Hunkins Home Improvement, they specialize in vinyl siding, but they have so much more. They have aluminum, cedar, pine, they have storm windows and doors, prime windows and doors, replacement windows and doors, shutters, door hoods, seamless gutters, and it goes on and on, from insulation all down. Hunkins Home Improvements, you know, they're serving the Seacoast, and there is a number that you can call. You can call 1-800-842-SIDE within New Hampshire, or you can call 431-2690 at their Greenland office. Hunkins Home Improvements, helping us bring you this broadcast today.
And of course, the Shamrock Booster Club, one of the most active organizations I've seen coming down here before the game. They have people out here long before game time, getting everything set up, making sure everything is all right. And maybe later on we'll get a shot of that Shamrock banner, and you'll see how it pays off for them. They have been the league champions a number of years, and a number of years in a row, and they're gunning for it again in 88.
Third and 7 for the Little Green. Stacy will air that ball out. Look at that pass. And it's caught by Barclay, and Barclay will be in for a touchdown. Stacy threw that ball 30 yards in the air.
And not a lot of loft on it, too. He had it pointed, nice tight spiral as to where he wanted it to go, and they've been trying that Stacy to Barclay all afternoon. And
it had to pay off
eventually, and it did. This is a big moment in the game, though. We've seen a number of foiled conversions, especially on the two-point conversion, and will they be conservative and try to go with an extra point or try to run in the two-point conversion, which would put a lot of pressure on the Shamrocks to make their two-point conversion even if they come back? So this is where the Shamrock defense really needs to knuckle down, and Skip Tilley is going to do the best he can to keep Dover out of the end zone again.
It's tied up now, 12-12. But Dover can effectively win this game with a conversion. They're lining up on their 3-yard line. And Chandler will keep it himself. He's got some blockers on that left side. He's in there. The 2-point conversion. Check that. Stacy, not Chandler. Chandler is the quarterback for Portsmouth. That was Jeff Stacy.
Shamrocks 12.
Well, it looks as though that eventually the Shamrocks are stringing it out well enough so that Stacy wouldn't have been able to find a hole, and he was going to run out of room on the sideline, but he had just enough to skirt around the end and go into the end zone. And like I said, that really puts the pressure not only on the Shamrocks to get down into the end zone with a minute and 58 left, but then they have to make this 2-point conversion to tie up the ball game. So a critical moment for Dover, and they capitalize on it. But we've always got the Shamrocks always have Stanley, and they've always got ice cream.
And that ice cream is effective on a cold day like today, let me tell you. 1:58 to go in this ball game, 14-12 now in favor of Dover.
Got to remember, though, that the game isn't over, and they have